Good morning and welcome to Buxton United Methodist Church. We are so glad that you are here worshiping with us this morning. I want us to take a few look at a few announcements. So let's see what we have this week. Coffee fellowship following worship. If you're more comfortable with grab and go, it's a beautiful day outside. So please feel free to grab something and head on out. Keep up with your reading of the New Testament Challenge. We are almost through Luke's Gospel, Luke chapters 17 through 21. All right, and we have Wednesday morning Bible study starting at 9. We are actually finishing the Gospel of Luke this week, so that's pretty exciting. They're all excited because they've done their Luke readings, so I guess they're taking probably a couple weeks off if I know them. But anyways, that will be by Zoom or in person. There is a Mother's Day through Father's Day mission that we are doing, supporting UNCOR for the specific purpose of helping Ukrainian refugees. And so 100% of what we give goes to UNCOR. And if you look in the back, you will see envelopes decorated like the Ukrainian flag with blue and yellow. And you can just put your gift in there and folks will know right away what it is for. Anyone who is a viewer online, please feel free to send something in with a note attached so that you'll know what that is for. Let's see, June 12th. Renee, what can you tell us about our celebrating our graduates this year?
June 12th, we'll celebrate our wonderful graduates, Marissa and Elise. Also, Ron Adams is graduating, and we will have a nice gathering with some extra treats downstairs, as well as a wonderful ceremony up here, and the end of Sunday school celebration, too.
Wow, so lots of things will be happening on the 12th. Cards would be appreciated. There's going to be cake, a special coffee, fellowship time, so that's going to be an exciting time. I hope you can make it. Let's see what else we have. Oh my goodness. After worship today, we need your picture. You may remember a few weeks ago I shared with you that during the worst of the pandemic, before the vaccines were available and we were online worshiping by Zoom, we had a Lenten mission and we collected funds to go towards buying a well and solar energy for the Navajo. Well, we have been flagged as a church to be put into a publication, a United Methodist publication for people as an example of things. So we give God the glory for that. But they would like a picture of us. So I am asking everybody who can, after worship, if you would come, space yourselves out on the wheelchair ramp, and I will get a picture of you all, and that will include those that are worshiping in their cars as well, if we do it that way. So that would be wonderful. If you're able, please let me get your picture. All right, and now, if we have no others, let's prepare our hearts for worship.
Thank you. This is from Psalm 47. Clap your hands, all you peoples. Shout to God with loud songs of joy.
For God has ascended with shouts of triumph and trumpet of fanfare.
Our God is exalted on high, sovereign over all the nations.
Christ is Lord of our lives. Let's worship together on this glorious day.
Our opening hymn is Crown Him with Many Crowns on the screen or in the hymnal 327.
Thank you.
Our Old Testament reading this morning is Psalm 93. The Lord reigns, he is robed in majesty. The Lord is robed in majesty and is armed with strength. The world is firmly established, it cannot be moved. Your throne was established long ago, you are for all eternity. The seas have lifted up, O Lord, the seas have lifted up their voice. The seas have lifted up their pounding waves, mightier than the thunder of the great waters, mightier than the breakers of the sea. The Lord on high is mighty. Your statutes stand firm. Your holiness adorns your house for endless days, O Lord. And the epistle reading this morning is in Revelation. And it's 22, 12 through 14, 16 through 17, and 20 through 21. Behold, I am coming soon. My reward is with me, and I will give to everyone according to what he has done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. Blessed are those who wash their robes, that they may have the right to the tree of life and may go through the gates into the city. I, Jesus, have sent my angel to give you this testimony for the churches. I am the root and the offspring of David and the bright morning star. The Spirit and the bride say, come, and let him who hears say, come. Whoever is thirsty, let him come, and whoever wishes, let him take the free gift of the water of life. And number 20, he who testifies to these things says, yes, I am coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. The grace of the Lord Jesus be with God's people. Amen. Gospel reading is in Luke. He said to them, this is what I told you while I was still with you. Everything must be fulfilled that is written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets and the Psalms. Then he opened their minds so they could understand the scriptures. He told them, this is what is written, that Christ will suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and repentance and forgiveness of sins will be preached in his name to all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. I am going to send you what my Father has promised. But stay in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high. When he had led them out to the vicinity of Bethany, he lifted up his hands and blessed them. While he was blessing them, he left them and was taken up into heaven. Then they worshipped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy, and they stayed continually at the temple, praising God. Word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
And our next hymn is number 163 in the hymnal, or on the screen, Ask Ye What Great Thing I Know. Thank you, Marie.
Thank you.
It seems to me that it comes early now. I seem to remember that it used to be years ago later on. Am I right on that?
It used to be May 30th.
No,
so 31st.
31st. So that's what it is. Okay. It always seems to sneak up on me now. So it has done that. And I don't know about the rest of you, but I'm playing catch up. So Memorial Day weekend is upon us, and we know that Memorial Day is a day of remembrance. Well, so is Ascension Sunday, which is what we are also celebrating today. And it is a good thing, I guess, for that reason that they overlap. That makes it nice and easy for us, doesn't it? All of our remembering. And remembering is a very biblical concept. Our God has called us to remember all the ways that we have been provided for and cared for and protected over the course of our lives. We're also told in the scriptures that we must remember to teach our children these important things as well. We're to pass that on to the next generation. Another thing that we are called to remember is biblical stories of remembrance. And when I think of the biblical stories of remembrance, I don't know about you, but the first one that pops into my mind is the story of the Exodus from the Old Testament. In the book of Exodus, chapter 12, verse 14, God gives instructions concerning the Passover. And it is written, "And this Passover day will be a day to remember, and you will keep it as a feast to the Lord throughout all the generations. You will keep it as a yearly feast forever." We know that Jesus, our Lord, was in fact celebrating that very feast of the Passover. And the Passover was that time when the people remembered the many ways that God had saved the people of Israel over the years. They remembered how God delivered them from slavery when they were in bondage in Egypt. And they remembered how God had delivered them when they were wandering in the wilderness. They remembered how God delivered them safely into the promised land, as God had promised. Well, during that Passover meal that Jesus was sharing with his disciples, we call it the Last Supper, Jesus said to his disciples, "A new covenant I give you, remember, as often as you do this in remembrance of me." And those, of course, are words that we share to this day when we have our communion celebration. But I must say, remembering is hard, especially the older we get. Goodness, if you knew the story that happened here this morning, I'm going to go ahead and tell it because it fits. We came in frantically looking for the hymnals because we needed them to sing the choir hymn this morning for our little chapel pickup choir. And we kept looking and saying, "Where are the hymnals? They're gone. Who would walk out of the church with all the hymnals?" We had forgotten that our old hymnals were blue and the new ones are red. So see, we failed to remember that, and we went all through the building looking for the lost hymnals when finally our sweet Jean, who's the youngest of us all, by the way, she remembered that they were red. And the rest of us felt so silly. She stopped, and she yelled down to the other two sisters, asking them, "Girls, do you remember? Was I going up or down?" Moments later, the second sister said, "I'm hungry. I'm going to the kitchen to get a bite to eat for a snack before bed." And so off she went. She got out of her chair and made her way in. But once she was in the kitchen, she hollered back to her other sister in the living room, asking, "What did I come in the kitchen for? I can't remember." When the second sister returned with her snack that her older sister told her she needed to go in there for in the first place, the third sister looked at her, shook her head, and she sat down to do a word find puzzle. "Well, thankfully," she said, "I'm not as forgetful as the two of you." And then she said, "Oh goodness, where did I put my glasses and my pen?" Sounds familiar, right? I don't know about you, but I've done all three of those things. I'm forever going up and downstairs because I've forgotten something. And several times I've opened the refrigerator door only to wonder what was it that I was actually going there looking for. And when it comes to glasses and pens, I have simply decided I need to leave a pair in every room because I always forget where I put them. Thankfully, though, remembering the goodness of our God is easier than remembering where we put our glasses, why we went into the kitchen, and whether or not we are going up or down the stairs. And on this Memorial Day weekend, as we recall that the origins of this holiday are for remembering all those who have lost their lives in war, but over the years, we've also come to remember all those whom we've loved but have lost in death. If our loved one's final resting place is in a cemetery, we often go and decorate them with flowers for the summertime. This week, my family did that. We had my Aunt Jimmy's memorial service followed by the burial, and she was laid to rest in the cemetery where most of the family has a final resting place. Grandparents, aunts and uncles, and their children even, for generations. And we were able to decorate with flowers and also be blessed by hearing the stories of these people whom the younger ones had never met. From the memories of my father, these were his grandparents and great-grandparents and his aunts and uncles and cousins. I know that all of you have precious memories of family members and friends whom you remember at this time every year too. But as we said, today is also Ascension Sunday. The actual day we celebrate Ascension is 40 days after Easter, which always falls on a Thursday. We're not here on a Thursday. So we honor it the Sunday after, much like we do with Epiphany in the Christmas season. Very rarely does the 12th day of Christmas fall on a Sunday. Well, it's likewise with Ascension, which always falls, as we said, on a Thursday. We remember it, though, in worship, and we honor it, but we sometimes forget the significance of our Lord's Ascension, as it plays second fiddle to Easter. On Easter morning, we rightly celebrate Christ's victory over sin and death, providing a way for us to be redeemed from our sins. But we forget that his ascension has great meaning too. It is because of the ascension that Christ our Lord is high and lifted up, able to oversee all the final events that will lead to his second coming. It is because of the ascension that we know that Christ, our risen Lord, Christ intercedes on our behalf for our prayers. If the ascension never happened, then Christ would not be able to prepare that special place for each and every one of us that he promised he would. If Christ had not ascended, there would be no reason to have hope for a future with him in heaven. For we know he has gone to prepare a place for all who believe, whose names are written, the scriptures say, in the book of life. Therefore, all those whom we love who believed but have died, we have the assurance that our goodbyes on this earth are not truly the end. As we decorate and memorialize their graves, fallen soldiers as well as family and friends, we can have peace. Peace and confidence that we will see them again. On the day when every knee will bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. But there's still one more thing that is important about Christ's ascension. It was at this time that Luke's gospel tells us that our Lord opened the minds of the disciples to understand the scriptures. Then he told them that the Holy Spirit would be coming. That means that without the ascension, Christ's disciples, both then and now, would never have had the clarity of thought to understand and interpret the scriptures. Nor would we have eyes to see and minds to understand the promises of God given to us in the scriptures. We wouldn't have been able to discern the work that needs to be done right here, right now, while we wait for his return. That we have work to do, hard work, to bring God's kingdom here on earth. This is why we pray in the Lord's Prayer, "Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven." That's the job that we've been left to do. It's why the angel said to the disciples, "People of Galilee, why do you stand looking up to heaven? Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven." Well, I can almost hear the voice of the angel speaking to us all today. "People of Buxton, let's go. It's time to get busy. Continue our Lord Jesus' work. Make faithful disciples who, like you, will work hard as well." There's a saying that I love: discipleship is not a spectator sport. Discipleship requires daily practice, just like athletes practicing for a sport, working to bring God's kingdom on earth as it is in heaven. So what does that mean for each and every one of us? What does that look like? It means that we're able to create a world that is beautiful, a world that is filled with kindness and compassion, a world that loves unconditionally as Christ Jesus loved us unconditionally, a world that is filled with forgiveness, even when people don't deserve forgiveness. Because we know that we all have fallen short of the glory of God. Not one of us has deserved God's forgiveness, and yet we've been given it. But God's amazing grace needs to be shared and spread that good news throughout the world. And this is the importance of Christ's ascension. Those who are the things that we need to remember, that our work is not over. As we look around and think, we must be getting close to our Lord's return. We see events happening in our world that jump right off the pages of the book of Revelation. Well, that may be, but no one knows the date and the hour of our God's return. But even so, we are not to stop doing the work we're called to do. Each one of us needs to live in such a way that we're bringing the obedience to God's will that is done in heaven right here to earth. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. May we never lose heart to do this work. May we never lose faith. May we never lose courage. And may we never lose the endurance to do this good work. Until the very last trumpet sounds, Lord God, we will remember to be your faithful disciples. And we thank you, O God, for giving us this great hope. Amen. It's time now to come before our God in prayer, and I would remind you to please try to use only the first names of folks as you lift them up, but we'll go ahead and pray, and we'll have a time to lift up those names. Let's be in a spirit of prayer. Oh, Lord God, we thank you so much that you are now, in fact, in heaven preparing that place for us, and that you are interceding for our prayers, even now, as we pray. And we know, Lord God, that not only do you hear prayers, but you answer them. So we come before you now, Lord God, lifting up all of those concerns that we have, as well as celebrations, Lord. But we remember things from our community, our nation, our world, we specifically pray, Lord God, for the war in the Ukraine to stop. And we remember all of those people, the poor parents who lost their children's lives when their children went to school because of an internal terrorist, really, who went into a school who would do such a thing. We pray for them and their loss. We can't even fathom what it would be like. And now we lift up to you, Lord God, all of those things in this moment of quiet.
Scott Schubert, Ben, Scott, Sharon, Steve.
Patty and the family of her sister who passed away.
Roy.
Bill.
Cindy.
Lord God, for all of these things that have been spoken and the many others that remain quiet on our hearts, we give them to you. And now we pray the prayer that Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Well, it is the last Sunday of the Easter season, so we'll be sharing for one more time the Apostles' Creed. So would you please stand, and we'll share that together. It is 882 in the hymn.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit,
will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
And our final hymn this morning is All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name, number 154, on the screen as well. Knowing that God's presence and power will go with you.